Okay, this is Dragon of Journey, and welcome back to Persona 3 Portable. Now, in the last episode, we had went through the midterm exams, and in this episode, we are going through the second half of the first Tartarus block. So, yeah, I guess first thing I should say as I'm checking through this stuff is this is post-commentary. All the other episodes were live commentary, but this is post. Mainly because there were a lot of edits. So yeah, I'm looking through the quests, I'm looking through the social links, I'm looking through the statuses of everyone, showing what armor they have. And I believe I show off the personas next? Aye. So let's see, Jack Frost, that heart. I don't think I've ever talked about that heart before. In fact, I don't think I've ever shown off that heart before. But that heart, if you level Jack Frost up, if he has a heart, or any persona, if they have a heart thing, you'll get an item. So I've shown off all my personas, and I'm going into the 16th floor. And Mitsu is just talking about, hey, the first barrier's gone, let's go to the next one. So, yeah, post-commentary. I had an original idea of recording this with a friend. So I decided to record it all at normal speed, without commentary. It took me about an hour and a half, or an hour and 40, 50 minutes. I still have the original recording somewhere. And yeah, I just decided to speed it up and was going to do stuff with Corey in order to get this episode done. I showed off the finished footage to Corey, and he said, dude, you gotta make some edits. So I made some edits. And I've only showed off the interesting shit. So it's back to normal speed, and it's pretty much the first floor to show basically what I'll be doing for the next however many floors I'm going through. Showing off the bosses and any interesting things that happen along the way. So yeah, and I guess why you can't hear Corey at the moment. Schedules and time zones and stuff are falling flat. So, yeah, he might appear in a future episode, maybe the next full moon operation, next Taurus tower climb. But, well, for this episode, I'm going solo. And, oh yeah, looking at the footage now. Yukari's outfit. I believe I've mentioned this a few times throughout the series, or if I haven't, then first time talking about it. Certain characters with certain equipment change their appearance. Like, Yukari's wearing a battle gear. Yeah. And they can't actually comment on the outfit you give them. But, well, I guess something I discovered. When you first load up the game, they'll comment on it. But if you reload the game, they won't. So it's like the first time you start up the game, they'll say something. And no matter how many reloads you go through, they won't say it again. Yeah, learned that the hard way, so I did want to get a comment about Yukari. I do get the comment at the beginning of the next episode, though, so that's something for you guys. So, what else can I talk about while we're going for the first floor? Well, I guess I could recap the story in case people are confused with balls. Yeah, so, to sum it up, we're transfer students. We can, for some reason, summon personas, potentially for a contract thing. We're being recruited by a group of people in order to fight shadows and explore Tartarus for answers. We've done one full moon mission where we've defeated a shadow that took over a train. Akiko has recovered from his first injury. Well, I say first, his only injury. And we've been covering a potential user called Fuka Yamagishi. So, yeah, maybe we'll learn more about her in the future episodes, and yeah, at the moment, we're just training in Tartarus and increasing the social links so we can get better personas. And really, that's pretty much about it. We just go through a school year, we increase our social links, we do the full moon operations, and we progress the story. So you can actually potentially go through the entire game without doing any social links. I wouldn't recommend it. Ego has a funny comment if you do that. But I wouldn't recommend it. Maybe as a speedrun, as a challenge run, people would do it. I've never been a speedrun of Persona 4. I'm sure some people are trying that. And Persona 4. So yeah, that's about it for the story. Now, I'm wondering how much of this floor there is left. I can see why people might have gotten bored when I did the original commentary over the first floors. I'll definitely be doing it in this format from now on. Let's see, we have these shadows here. What do I do here? Nugsy Myers. Reticles! Lovely. Yeah, it's about a quarter of the video in and I've already run out of things to say. Lovely. So, I guess I can just talk about random crap while I'm doing this. Let's see, at the time of recording this, it is Valentine's Day. Interesting note. So yeah, Valentine's Day. For all you single people, I know the feeling, I'm single right now. In fact, I've always been single. For those who are in relationships, you lucky, lucky people. Treasure your partner always. Unless they're decent, in which case, get away from that. That really took a dark turn. So let's see, what did I get with this shovel time? Oh, I would have went for experience. Do I show off any levels up? Or level ups in this video? I don't think so, and by the looks of it, we've explored all of the floor. So, lovely, I might end up editing these first floor explorations out from now on. I might keep them in. Why not keep it as Phantom Mage fighting? Because all fights are first floor. Oh no, wait, no, I need them now. The quests, I had to kill them for the bloody quest items. And Ikari does not have any figure on her. I know it's a PS2/PSP game, but still. I'm so looking forward to Persona 5. I just need to get a PS4 first. And we've just skipped about 7-8 floors. Yeah, cut out quite a bit there. Now, if people do want to see the full footage of... Yeah, people do want to see the full footage of me going through the floors, and I do have it. I'll probably upload it as a 0.5 video like I did with Spore videos. I still can't believe that Spore was pretty popular. Or at least with my channel. I do a full playthrough of Spore Space Stage, and it's probably one of the most watched things on my channel. So, floor 25, we have the first boss. It is the Crying Table. So, I'm reading this directly from the wiki. Three Crying Table Shadows act as a sub-boss found on the 25th floor of Taurus in Aqua Block. They impede player's progress and must be beaten to proceed. The Crying Table later reappears as a regular enemy in the Aqua Block of Taurus between floors 48 to 63, and the boss on the 8th floor of... It's my something. Polonia? Polonia? With the Rondrus, Magus, and Katania. So, for note, these guys are weak to ice. I decided to have the... Jack Frost for this. It was a good idea, however, well...
Are you alive?
Yeah... Jack Frost is weak to fire. So that's a bit... Yeah. Nearly died. Yeah, just keep healing myself. If I die, everyone dies, which... is kind of bullshit. I could have just used a revival bead on myself. That may not happen in Persona 5. I keep mentioning Persona 5, but I am looking forward to it. Too tired to get up. And Yukari is dead. I think I just spend this whole time trying to heal myself. Oh, and there's poison which missed. Lovely. Now I gotta question the eye of the enemies. They could have easily just used Miragi and killed me, but they didn't. They could have killed me. I could have had a game over and had to reload. But no, they didn't.
Attack again.
I don't understand that. And Junpei co-op. God, love the co-op. And Slag. Here's a chance. Let's get him. And then just an all-out attack. And they should be dead. Yes, they are. Yay! So we did it. Everyone gets experience. Except Yukari. Yeah. Sorry, Yukari. I'm pretty sure I heal you now, right? Yeah, revival bead. And then I just heal everyone with D, alright? I feel like that's kind of pointless since I might just go back to previous floor. Maybe not. Bead chain! I did that boss for a bead chain. Well, technically, I did it for progression for Tartarus. I do have to wonder about something. Is it potentially possible to go through the entire game without going through the floors of Tartarus? I can maybe see that in a New Game Plus cycle, since you do have a different way to train up your characters, but yeah, that would be interesting. It'd be tedious as hell since it's about 255 floors, but still. Now, why did I keep this floor in? I gotta wonder, since there are some floors I keep in because of interesting stuff. I do keep a few Golden Shadow fights in, so I might be Golden Shadow. And I decided to just use Rush for this. Bubble Pool. He used on the guy who's blocking ice. And table's dead. Too bad. So sad. Do I just go for the experience with the shuffle time? I do. I gotta say, shuffle times, it's actually, I don't know, it's kind of easy to keep an eye on the card like you want. For some things, it's not that easy, but I don't know, I just find it pretty easy. Oh, there it is. Right, what's the technique I use for this? If this was Fez, then I could easily just use a bow and attack it myself, but no, this is portable. I can only use a one-handed sword. And interruption by Junpei, you found the stairs. And they get into the fight. Lovely. Now, I think I find a good way to finally kill these things. Teach it a lesson. Shall I hopefully show off here? Let's see, I'm looking through Jack Frost skills. Nothing's gonna work against it. So I swap to Archangel. Archangel does have a move here, but I don't use it in this fight though. Will Homer work? Will it work me? Will it work? No, it doesn't.
One enemy remains.
So yeah, that plan went out the window. Turns out there is an easy way to kill us. And I only just discovered it in this fight, I think. Either that fight or the next fight. No. Treasure Hand, 100 HP. Is it this turn? Yes, it is. they're weak to pierce. Yukari can one-shot these things. All the times I messed up in the previous fights of these guys, and they were just weak to Yukari, of all things. Oh, yeah, I already have Brass Knuckles. So that might be it for this floor. Oh god, weak HP for everyone. Did I heal? I hope I did. Oh no, I think I didn't. Oh, I think this is an example of a fight like Oh. I don't necessarily have a game over, but it goes very, very wrong. Very wrong. I'm the only one alive, for some stupid reason. I decide to put Rush on. I mean, their ice attacks aren't doing anything to me, but they can still attack.
Push yourself.
Yeah, that is a really bad fight. Everyone's dead. That reminds me, I still don't show off the Reaper. I'll try and show him off eventually. I mean, I do have to fight him for Elizabeth quests late in the game. So I'll definitely be showing him off. And, yep, next floor. This is floor 31. Is floor 31 me? Yes, it is. So I believe this is another Golden Hand floor, I think. Oh yeah, go heal everyone up and save because that was disastrous. Yeah. Fights can, and usually will, kill you. You'll think you're doing well, you're going for floors, and then you just have a bad fight and die and game over. Yeah. It sucks. It really sucks. Now back in floor 31. When do I fight a shadow? Or when do I fight the golden shadow stick? I believe it's coming up. Eventually. Looks panicked. Really. Now, might as well mention a little bit about Akihiko. I could have potentially done something with his boots. I could have gotten some better boots. But I don't know what was up with me recording at the time. I didn't. And I guess I can't remember since it was about a month or two ago. Yeah, I recorded these quite a bit in advance. Oh, Golden Shadow. You two, fight the Golden Shadow!
Seek out and it flees.
Oh, this is actually a funny moment.
Everyone, return to the leader.
I turn to Yukari.
So annoying.
I turn to Yukari. And there was another golden shadow around the corner. So one ends up fleeing, but I find one.
That's a rare form.
Don't know if it's funny per se, but hey. I managed to find another golden shadow, which is quite nice. Quest help. No, oh yeah, the others are fighting, so they can't help me. Yeah, that kind of sucks. So yeah, switch to Archangel. Do I finally get the right idea now? No, not Hammer again. Oh, Super Card. Actually, that might help. Hidden Invasion Raid up. I guess Archangel got a pierce attack. Maybe it's through leveling him up? I don't know. Oh well. So then it's another normal shadow fight.
Three enemies present. Roger. I'll attempt to analyze the enemy.
Do I just go for attacking? Do I put on to rush? No, I decided to use actual attacks. Okay. That weak to Z.O. Attack them with the Z.O. Go Z.O.
Easy, senpai.
And now I've got the Power Rangers Eel. Oh, I haven't watched Power Rangers ages. What are they up to? Actually, what I should be asking is, what is Super Sentai up to? I don't know. I mean, last I heard in the Super Sentai series, they were using children who were using imagination and trains. Like, no, not Gokaiger. Oh, Tokyuga? Something like that? I don't know. I'm rambling now. Boss floor! Lovely, so how many floors did I skip? About 4 or 5. Okie doke. And then the usual, go back to floor 1 and save before boss. Aye. Now if I go on towards the wiki and I check the boss name of this guy. Right, I'll get into the fight and I'll explain him a bit. So, go left me. Left. Right. There he is. Prepare yourself! Okay, so this guy is Change Relic. Sakara is the Empress.
So it'll be a difficult fight.
A sub-boss found on the 36th floor of Taurus. It impedes the player's progress and must be beaten to proceed. Protagonist may make use of Fortuna's wind resistance for this battle, as she can be fused from the Chimera and Inugami cards, collected during shuffle time in the Aqua Block, once the protagonist reaches level 17. Alp may also be collected during shuffle time as a weak alternative. Well, I don't think I use either of those, so whoever dirt me. The Change Relic will also make frequent use of its Poison and Mist skill. So having this poisons on hand will mitigate the problem if it poses. Also, once the player reaches level 17, the Wind Charm accessory becomes available at B Blue V for 7,000 yen.
Let's go.
I don't think I've ever been to B Blue V yet. Maybe in the PSP version, it's just the police station. Maybe. Which can be used to bolster Junpei Yori with the Dodge Wind ability. In the answer of Persona 3 FES, it appears as a regular enemy in Empyrean. I still haven't decided whether I'm actually going to do the answer or not. I mean, it's an important part of the story in Persona 3, but, well, I have never went through it. I mean, Persona 3, I've went through it once. Persona 4, I've went through it once. The answer, I haven't been through, so I'd be either going through it completely blind, or I would have to go through it as I'm recording this, which might not be a bad idea. I guess people watching this, people who like the Persona series, do you want to see me go through the answer? I mean, I could potentially ask Corey about it. There's a thought. So, actually, if I check, I would say if I check Skype. No, I don't have Skype up because I want the internet to work well. Oh well. So, skills this guy has. A bit late to be talking about skills, but he has Garula. He has Magarula. He has Rakukarja, he has Poison Mist and Deer, so he deals wind damage, he can increase his defense, he can poison everyone, and he can restore himself. And he is known for Wind, Light, and Dark. I never actually went through the Grand Kill one, did I? Strong against Slash, Null against Strike, Strong against Pierce, Rain against Fire, Heat against Ice, Null against Light and Dark. So, like I said during the boss fight, it's a weekend's nice. Okay. Yeah, this fight's going on for a while, and everyone is poisoned but me. I didn't make use of Cadenza much. It is quite nice. It's a heal and it's evasion up. Can't go wrong with evasion up. And poison. Poison! Watch out! A poisonous move! I've been watching King's Quest V too much. Well, not really too much. I just saw the stream Luca did about the game. It should still be in the bots by the time it's uploaded. It's only been a few days since I've watched it, so it should be. And it was recorded this month. That reminds me, I wonder if people are going to be doing any Valentine's streams today. You know, some people might just want to spend a day together. Should we just say, good on ya? I wish I had always been here. Oh, that's just my bad luck. Sorry. And the boss is dead. Lovely. Queen of Coins. And you're level 15. You're level 15. I didn't see what my level was. You know, if I could stop going through this thing so quickly, I could tell. Ah, well. I'm gonna guess I'm not level 17. Maybe I am. Maybe I'm just being an idiot. Now, do I go through the last few floors, or do I go straight to the... I go straight to the dead end. Okay. So, we've reached the barrier. Lovely. Return to the entrance. We are done. Yay. Old document too. Do I read it, or do I save it for next time? Yeah, I can't go any further till the next full moon. Sad. I haven't actually recorded the next part yet. Yeah, I still need to record the Fuka video properly. Yeah, there's a plan. Oh well. Now that I'm actually back into the recording mood, I might try to do that this week. There's a plan. And I was level 17. I could have had Fortuna. Aye. And so I show everyone off. And I actually gave Akigo some better boots. Lovely, so... yeah, I guess that is the end of the video, so... yeah, I guess with that, I will do my outro here. This has been Dragon of Journey going through more Persona 3 Portable. In this episode, I went through the second half of the Aqua Block? Aqua Block? It's not Aqua. Arca? Arqua? However you pronounce it. So yeah, I beat the Guardians, I got to the barrier, and... yeah, next episode, I believe I go back to, like, social link stuff. So, yeah. And for... well, I guess as a last note, for those who want to see the full thing of me going through Tartarus, I will upload that 0.5 video tomorrow. It'll probably be at 300% speed. It'll... or 200%, I haven't decided. Probably 300% speed. So, 3x speed, no commentary. If you guys like that kind of thing, then... it should be up. So, with my rambling done viewers, until next time.